What I'm going to do here is try to pull a little more light out of this. And again, kind of bring that light out a little bit more. Okay. And you don't want the whole area up here being super, super bright. Because then what ends up happening is that, you don't have that soft transition that you're supposed to have. Okay. So what I'm going to do, as you can see, I'm putting a little bit more tone back in here, even though I know I pulled some out earlier. And you can see, I'm kind of almost like I'm coming down, I'm grabbing the charcoal and I'm pushing it back up. So if you do that, then again, it just lets you kind of grab it and what it does is it also, helps it look a little softer. Since this is a round form, that's what you want. You don't want like it is with a cube, where it's this hard edge, that it's a sudden change. You want softer transitions. Like I said here, I'm gonna pull a little bit back out. That's what you'll find a lot of this is just kind of subtracting and adding, okay? And then again, back down on this part. Sort of the same thing. So I'm gonna grab and kind of pull it. And there we go. And so on the bottom, and actually I'm gonna probably go ahead and use the charcoal pencil just because that stick of charcoal I have, it didn't really sharpen very well, so. And I actually didn't sharpen this pencil as well as I should have. I'm gonna kind of get that shape in there that I need of this, little sphere. And so you can see like here, I'm actually drawing a lot more with my wrist, which is fine because now, I went from big to small. This is the big shape, now down to the, the little details. All right, let's go ahead and get that. And then I'm gonna put my blending stump somewhere. I can't find it now. So usually, sometimes depending on the lighting, your cast shadow can be like really close to black, but really it's kind of a darker gray. And so like I said, I felt like I put a little too much there. So I knocked it back for a second, and I'm gonna kind of build this back up again. Right up against where it really touches. I'm gonna go ahead and darken that up a little more just to give it that little pop. And again, the very edges of this are just a little fuzzy, so you just don't want a hard line against there. And we'll actually kind of make it that there's a table here. I'll put it like there, so then that line's gonna start there. So I'm gonna have to re-darken all that stuff again, but that's okay. Again, I'm trying to avoid lines, even though I use lines to indicate where I want things. I don't really want the lines to show up. In the final product. And again, here we are. So actually, I think I'm going to use the blending stuff instead. Let's try to get that edge of the table first. I'm going to do that. And then there we go. Okay, so now that I have that, like I said, I'm going to go ahead and pull some of this light back out. And again, all I'm doing is just kind of cleaning my eraser right there. And this edge is something that I would keep working on because I don't think I have it quite like I want to, but I'm gonna kind of, I think I'm just gonna let it go for now. Keep this video from being too long. There we go, that's what happened. Maybe I just need to get a better eraser. That could be it right there. There we go. Like I said, I'm just going to kind of soften the edge of these little bits of that shadow, and we'll call it done. Again, there's little things here I could make a little crisper and darker. But after these couple of lines here, we'll call it done. And let's just say that that's it. There we go. Okay.